Who are you, Calliope Burns? Why do you show up now? I can't shake the fear that as soon as I blink, you'll disappear.
First Kill is a modern love story between two teenage girls, one being a vampire, one being a monster hunter.
Their families are rivals from centuries before they were born, and they're trying to create and find this love that they didn't expect to have for one another. They're also trying to find their identities and who they are outside of who they were predestined to be.
The Burns, they're human, and they're hunters. The hunter's duty is to protect humanity.
They are a family of monster hunters, but they still sit around the table having dinner, you know, past the potatoes. And oh yeah, did you see that vampire that we staked last night?
Calliope Antigone Burns is the youngest and the only female in a family of two boys. Her biggest thing is just trying to prove to her family that she deserves respect as a monster hunter instead of just teenage little sister.
Calliope knows exactly who she is. From the time she was 2 years old, she's watched and trained to be a hunter. Whereas Juliette's in a family that she doesn't want to be what they are.
Juliette does not want to be a vampire. She just wants to be a normal girl.
The vampires, they go back thousands of years. It's a very matriarchal situation.
We survive by our commitment to blending in.
First Kill legacy vampires are different because they can't be killed with a stake through the heart. As a result, you have a group of people who can live seemingly forever without any natural predators.
Margot, you have such lovely skin.
What's your secret?
Sunscreen.
Legacy vampires, they have this ritual when a legacy vampire makes their first kill or their first feeding.
There's all of this pressure to drop the whole, I want to be human, I want to be normal, and really embrace this incredible matriarchy.
Calliope does her best work under pressure. She's up for the challenge of her first kill.
Once Juliette and Calliope meet, everything that happens to both families happens because two people who never should have fell in love.
It's almost like a modern day Romeo and Juliet, but spicier. The whole show is a back and forth of love and duty and passion and power.
You're a monster, and I'm a hunter. And there's only one way this story ends.
There's really human elements, even though it's this very big world filled with monsters and vampires and all sorts of creatures.
You get the fighting, you get the fantastical moments, but then you also get a story.
I'm not a monster.
Back off!
Everybody can find some sort of way to relate.
It's really exciting, really exhilarating. I think audiences will be obsessed with this story.